Tomorrow, thousands of people will be in downtown's East Village for opening day. Some who live and work in the area say that they have seen an increase in police enforcement there. When one advocate told us he believes that homeless people are being forced out before the game, our tennis reporter Amanda Brandeis took his concern straight to police.
You can see the final touches going into Petco Park before a highly anticipated opening day. But just a few blocks away from the stadium are the many faces of San Diego's homeless crisis.
Because right behind us, we have a huge homeless services complex. We also have the public library behind us and the transit station right over here.
Homeless advocate Michael McConnell spends many early mornings on the streets of downtown, documenting police interactions with the homeless population. Since the hepatitis A outbreak, he's seen the number of encampments go down, but is frustrated over the city's response to fixing the problem.
I'm most frustrated that there's not a strategy that's solutions focused. Long-term thinking about actually reducing homelessness versus reducing the visibility of homelessness.
McConnell took several pictures of officers around the stadium in East Village, making contact with the homeless.
When we have to send out massive amounts of law enforcement to clear an area to make things appear better versus them actually being better, we know we've failed.
San Diego Police says the timing of opening day has nothing to do with the enforcement, and they receive constant complaints from residents and businesses to address encampments, drug use, and other criminal activity. An SDPD representative says since last summer, they've responded to 5,000 of these requests through the Get It Done app alone. We're told with every contact, officers offer resources and help, which people often don't take.
So that's the first one that I saw.
But McConnell says based on what he witnesses day in, day out, he's not satisfied with their response. Amanda Brandeis, 10 News.
And we also heard from a spokesman for the mayor's office who says the police department's efforts to offer services to vulnerable people while also protecting quality of life in our neighborhoods does not change based on special events.